Shingre from 9A. My project name is a hydraulic powered lift. First, I'll explain you with theoretical base. A hydraulic device is a device which is used for moving object from one place to another using force created by pressure on a liquid in the cylinder that moves the piston upwards. Incompressible oil is pumped into the cylinder, which forces the piston upwards. When a valve opens to release the oil, the piston moves downward due to the gravitational force. Hydraulic systems are used for all sorts of things, from car braking systems to forklift trucks, presses to pumps. All these systems use same basic principle, and hydraulic lifts are no different. The main components used in hydraulic elevators are piston within a cylinder, which is also called as a ramp, oil reservoir or tank, valve, motor to drive a pump, etc. Usually a hydraulic lift has machine room, which house the pump, liquid, fluid and motor. So you may need more space than expected. Now I'll show my practical model of hydraulic lift. The basic homemade sample components used in this project are syringe A, catheter, syringe B, cardboard, toy car, radium paper, toothpicks, nuts, hydrogen and colors. I'll show you the practical use of this. When the oil pushes into the piston moves upward, and when the valve is open, the oil is allowed to flow back into the reservoir and the piston comes downward due to the gravitational force. This can be used in a better way in our future generations. We can also use this for parking cars. And we can make a use of it in more better way due to lack of places in corporates, buildings. These methods are used. And this is how the hydraulic lifts are works.
Hello each and everyone, myself Siddhant Vaithe from Standard 12 Division A. On the occasion of Engineers Day, we have prepared a project based on the subject of windmill. And we would like to give some information about it, introduction about it, also share some advantages about it, and also a short summary of how we prepared the project.
Sohum Sanjay Vanjiwale, 12AMM. A windmill. A windmill is a structure that converts wind power into rotational energy by means of vanes called sails or blades, specifically 2 mm grain. But the term is called extended to wind pumps, wind turbines and other applications. The term wind engine is sometimes used to describe such devices.
I would like to talk about some advantages and disadvantages of windmill. The energy which we obtain through windmill is called wind energy. Let's talk about the advantages first. It is a renewable and clean source of energy. The operating cost is also low and it takes efficient use of land space. Now, let's talk about the bad side of it, which we also call as disadvantages. It creates a lot of noise and visual pollution. It is also intermittent. It also has some adverse environmental impact, which can harm our lives also. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Chaitanya Bagde from Dr. Antonio De Silva Technical High School, Dadar, Mumbai. I am from Standard 12, Division B. On the behalf of this Engineering Day, I have prepared a project based on the topic of wireless energy transfer, that is Tesla coil. What is a Tesla coil? A Tesla coil is a radio frequency oscillator that produces high voltage with low current. Works on the principle of electromagnetic induction, according to which when a conductor is placed under a varying magnetic field, a small current is induced inside the conductor.
Image of a Tesla coil. Inventor of Tesla coil. Now I am placing all the components on the wooden board, and now I am joining it with the help of glue gun. After attaching all the components on the wooden board, now I am winding the wires and then soldering it. Winding helps the wire to solder strong and it will not be broken easily. After the winding of the wire, now I am going to solder it. Soldering will give the final strongness so that the winding will not get out easily. After the winding, now I am going to coil a wire which will act as a secondary coil. The pipe which I am coiling is of the same size as that of the hollow cylinder. After that, I am soldering all the necessary wires according to the diagram of the circuit. Now I am joining the wire of resistor to the switch as well as the battery, and then joining the secondary wire with the transistor, resistor and the switch, and after that I am soldering it. Now after soldering the battery to the resistor as well as transistor, now I am soldering it with the switch. This is how the final Tesla coil
here looks. You can see the bulb is not glowing as it is not in the range of the Tesla coil. Once it will be in the range of Tesla coil, the bulb will start glowing as there will be wireless energy transfer. So here the bulb starts glowing wirelessly with the help of Tesla coil.
Stephen Hawking has rightly quoted, whether you want to uncover the secrets of the universe or you just want to pursue a career in the 21st century, basic computer programming is an essential skill to learn. Yes, indeed, information technology plays a vital role in today's world. Be it your career, communication, or even shopping online these days. Good morning, respected management, staff, and my dear friends. We represent Class 12C, IT and Bio Division. Our group members consist of Master Alden D'Souza, Master Nas Sayed, and Master Abhishek Singh, guided by our very own IT professor, Mrs. Lydia Gonsalves.
Our main aim and goal of our project is to show each one of you how a single website can be a blooming flower to any startup. So we created a basic website which is relevant to all of us, and that is nothing but our own college website using the elements and tags which we learn in coding through the year through the textbook.
To develop this website, we have used HTML, CSS and JavaScript. HTML provides the basic structure of sites, which is enhanced and modified by other technologies like CSS and JavaScript. CSS is used to control the presentation, formatting and layout, and JavaScript is used to control the behavior of different elements. So what are you waiting for? Let's get started and get a quick overall view of our very own website.
Website is the folder in which we have saved all the coding and the images which will be used for the website. The login page opens up the home page. On the left bottom you can see images which will move in a sequence with the help of a loop. On the right, the user has to enter his name and stream which he belongs to. The very first link is for instructions. Click here for proceeding, directs you to the previous page. There are four subject links. The first link is for IT students. Followed by MM, EM and SS. Some of the very famous engineers who have succeeded in their field. And the last link is for giving a feedback and aptitude test. Here we have used form tags so that the user can enter his details and his views. And there's a submit button and a reset button. The last link is for feedback using the same elements. Thank you.
I'm Sajan Rajesh Lad from 9th. My topic is hydraulic lift. Hydraulic lift is a type of machinery that uses the hydraulic apparatus to lift or move the object using force created when the pressure is exerted on the piston. The force then produces the lift and work. The hydraulic technology has a multitude industrial application like construction and transport. It is often implemented to operate heavy materials from one place to another like cars, dirt and shipping containers. So I'll show you it practically in my project. So let's see how hydraulic works.
This is a chocolate dispenser. To make this chocolate dispenser, we need few things, few materials that we have in our home. The materials are cardboard, glue, rubber band and paint. If you want to decorate, you can decorate or paint. So first, I took cardboard and cut it into rectangular box shape and then I took one more cardboard and stick in the box lightly and took one more cardboard and make small size boxes to fill chocolates in it and then stick the boxes on a plain cardboard
and stick that cardboard on which I stick small boxes in the box above the slantly cardboard. And then took a thin cardboard for push button and one small square shape cardboard and stick a very small shape cardboard on this and our chocolate dispenser is ready and when we will push it the chocolate will come and then chocolate will come outside slidingly with the help of slantly cardboard. I painted it with dark blue, light green, light blue and red color. I took lots of effort to complete this. So my chocolate dispenser is ready and you can also try. Thank you, sir.
Hello friends and teacher. We, Prashant and Pavitra Yadav, are presenting our project which is made to learn about hydraulic system. So, what we need to make it? Let's see.
We have used cardboard to make the body, tires, 9-volt battery, 5mm saline tube, wires, geared motor, micro switches. What is hydraulics?
Hydraulics is mechanical unit which operates through the force of liquid pressure. So, how it works? Let's see. This is for controlling hydraulic first arm. Let's see what's happened.
The force of liquid pressure raises the first arm. Let's press second and see what happens.
The liquid pressure pulls and raises second arm. Similarly, bucket also operate. Please press bucket syringe and see the movement. This is bucket.
We have also learned the reverse and forward motion of geared motors using micro switches.
These are micro switches which helps bulldozer to move forward, right, backward, left. These two switches are used for the movement of the upper body in left-right direction. Let's see the motion.
Forward. Backward. While turning bulldozer, one motor turns forward and other backward.
Let's see upper body movement. First we will turn it to left. Now, let's turn it to right. While making this project, we faced difficulties such as proper alignment of vehicle.
Turning of bulldozer was a challenge for us.
As saline tube was costly, so finding its replacement was a challenge and many more difficulties we faced.
Thank you for this opportunity.
Good morning, principal, teachers, and all my dear friends. My name is Tanish Kapoorchand Gupta. I am from 8B and my phone number 28.
My name is Mahesh Kumar. I am from 8B and my phone number 35.
My name is Shlomo English. I am from 8A. Roll number 41.
My name is Tanish Kapoorchand. I am from 8A.
My name is Niman Chappala. I am from 8B, room number 21.
am Saisu Ravi Anvandula from 8A, roll number 11.
Today we are presenting a hydrocarbon robotic power arm. If the materials are used in hydrocarbon power robotic arm is first some board, saline pipe, syringe, stick and cell.
The first gear is for moving arms. The second gear is for moving body. The third gear is for rotating body. The fourth gear and the last gear, but not least, is for moving hand. It is useful for brake and steering on car, hydraulic lift and jacks for servicing car.
Number is 20. Today I am presenting a project of hydraulic bridge system. Hydraulic bridge is a type of movable bridge which rises with the help of a hydraulic piston in order to allow maritime traffic. Pascal law is the principle behind it. As per the law of fluid at rest in closed container, a pressure change in one part is transmitted without loss to every partition of the fluid and to the wall of container. I have used 4 injections, 1, 2, 3 and 4 to create a hydraulic pressure. Now I will show you how piston work with the help of hydraulic pressure. Now have a look on my project making photos.
My name is Arjun Ghosh and I am from class 12A SS Division. My project is regarding aerodynamics. Aerodynamics, as the name suggests, is the dynamic motion of the air, which in other words is how the air moves around various objects under various conditions. Conditions include speed of the wind, direction of the wind, shape of the object the air is interacting with, weight of the object, gravitational pull on the object, drag, thrust, etc. It plays a major role in the physics behind the working of planes, cars, rockets, etc., as it directly or indirectly affects a lot of important factors such as fuel consumption, time of travel, etc. Now, while aerodynamics is a vast topic, let's discuss a few common terms used in it. Drag, a force that opposes the forward motion of an object in airflow. Lift, an aerodynamic force perpendicular to the direction of wind, which in other terms is the force that gets the weight off the ground. Turbulence is a highly irregular form of flow, with a fluid is subject to continual changes in speed and direction. Thrust is an artificial force applied to oppose the drag. In order to achieve flight, the thrust must be greater than the drag. Now let's talk about the aerodynamics in cars. Splitter, a leading edge on the front of the car relatively parallel to the ground, which attempts to keep the high pressure of the air on top of the car rather than flowing underneath it. The high pressure pushes down the splitter, also helping to create downforce. Dive planes. These fixtures are typically located on the left and right sides of the front bumper and are curved to redirect airflow at the front of the vehicle upward, thus creating downforce. They are also used to alter the air force along the sides of the vehicle, attempting to minimize the amount of high pressure air that enters underneath the car. Hood vents. Ventilated hoods allow clean exit for the air passing through the radiator, and they also help to maintain airflow throughout the engine bay, increasing cooling. NACA ducts. These air scoops are designed to have minimal impact on airflow while still creating an inlet for airflow. They can be used in nearly any application that requires airflow, whether that's feeding an intake air, a radiator, or even cooling for a driver. Side vents. Side vents can be seen behind the front wheels, allowing the airflow to exit the wheel wells, which typically remains turbulent from the rotation of the wheels. These can also be used to channel hot air out of the engine bay. Side skirt. Side skirts are somewhat similar in principle to splitters. They are in place and typically as low as possible in order to prevent high pressure air from moving underneath the vehicle. Underbelly. For racing, these are often smooth and flat to minimize drag and reduce turbulence underneath the vehicle. In combination with diffuser, the lower pressure air underneath the vehicle can create significant downforce. A diffuser is a portion of the underbody which is shaped to create a location increasingly larger air volume below the rear of the car. This allows for fast moving low pressure air underneath the car to decelerate and expand the rear of the vehicle. The diffuser helps to create and accelerate the air underneath the car, which reduces its pressure, thus improving downforce. It can also be redirected to airflow upward, further improving downforce. Spoilers. Spoilers on race cars are used to prevent lift by placing an obstruction in the path of lift creating airflow. This causes the path of the air to change so that the airflow at the rear of the vehicle leaves a horizontal upward manner, thus not producing lift. A similar feature can be seen when you are on a passenger plane that's landing. Flaps on the wings will lift, minimizing lift and thus creating drag, both of which assist in slowing the plane down.
How does electric car work?
Industry is laying a growing emphasis on the importance of using environmental technologies in car production. The car, which has achieved outstanding results in crash tests, has great stability, as the battery is fixed to the floor pan. There are several versions of the battery available, and it has an 8-year warranty. The 85 kilowatt-hour battery pack weighs 540 kilograms and has 16 modules containing 7,104 lithium-ion battery cells.
Components: electric traction motor. Using power from the traction battery pack, this motor drives the vehicle's wheel. Some vehicles use motor generators that perform both the drives and regeneration functions. Battery. In an electric drive vehicle, the auxiliary battery provides electricity to power vehicle's accessories. Charging port. The charging port allows the vehicle to connect
from Standard 9, Division A, Roll Number 51. I am making a mobile project for Engineering Day. The principle behind it is it works upon electromagnetic radiation. The idea behind a projector is that light rays coming from phone pass through a magnifying lens placed in a certain distance. This creates a bigger projected image. I have used a phone, a box, and a magnifying glass for making a mobile projector.
My name is Arjun Santosh Jadav and I am from Dr. Antonio Da Silva Technical High School from 9B. And today I am going to prepare a project for Engineers Day. And the topic of my project is how to generate electricity with the help of a windmill. And for this project, the materials that I am going to need are PVC pipe, T-joint, elbows, DC motor, fan blades, etc. The first step for making this project is to cut this PVC pipe according to your requirement. So these are the cuttings that I have made. And so for making the windmill, we have to first make it stand. And so now I am going to assemble these parts. So, see here, now I have connected two wires to the DC motor and put through this PVC pipe and connected toward these two terminals where we will get the generated electricity. Now I am going to put this DC motor inside the PVC pipe. Now I am going to attach this fan blade to the motor shaft. So, in order to generate electricity, we are going to use the DC motors according to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. In this law, the mechanical energy gets converted to electrical energy, and here the mechanical energy is generated because of the spin of the fan blades. Now I am going to provide wind flow to the windmill so that it can generate electricity. So we are going to get the generated electricity from these two terminals. Now I am going to put the fan on so that the airflow is provided. Now let's check how much electricity is getting generated with the help of this voltmeter. Now I am putting this voltmeter on. So now let's check the generated electricity. See, the generated electricity is around volts DC. So this is how the electricity is generated with the help of a windmill. Thank you.
Hello teacher, today we are making the vacuum cleaner and explaining how to make the vacuum cleaner. Hi, my name is Siddhesh Sanjay Garvi.
Hi, my name is Shashank Mahendra Chavan.
Hi, my name is Niraj Pradeep Tomre.
So we take 5 to 6 materials to make the vacuum cleaner, like 2 liter bottle, 1 tinned bottle, 2 9 volts battery, 2 connectors, 1 DC motor, and to decorate the bottle we take the shining tape.
First we take the 2 liter bottle and cut it in the center and make separate parts of the bottle. Downside of the bottle we make some holes to pass the air,
and where we make the holes there we stick the DC motor including fan into it, and we have take the filter paper because the garbage will stuck inside the fan, that's why we have take the filter paper.
So hello sir, this is our vacuum cleaner. We decorate the vacuum cleaner with the shining tape, and this is type of AC.
This is type of AC.
Sir, inside the bottle, the cloth is very washable, and there is the motor inside of the bottle, the fan. The fan of the bottle we make of the tinned bottle.
Sir, we have stick the motor downside of the bottle.
Sir, we have to stick the switch and the batteries upside of the bottle in this way. And we are showing how the full look of the vacuum cleaner.
Sir, This is the AC pipe where the garbage will come inside. Sir, this is the final look of vacuum cleaner.
We take very effort to make this.
Okay, vacuum cleaner.
Okay, thank you, sir. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, my dear friends and respected teacher. My name is Tanish Joshi, row number 21 from AT. I have made this machine using motor, blade and USB wire. This is used to cut any thin object like chili, ladyfinger, etc. Now I am showing how this machine works. I have completed this project. How is it?
Hi everybody. Good evening, sir, and all friends. My name is Jay Mahade Kotekar. My roll number is 38 from 8B.
Hi everybody, sir and students. My name is Vignesh Jay Prakash Gund, and my division is 8A, and my roll number is 14.
So we made that street light with
maker material, battery, fabric stick, two cars, cardboard, paper, light, and poster color and brush.
So here it is, that street light we made. This is battery. Then we use attach, then light flickers and on. And this is the brightness of this light.
Battery.
And we made that roll with cardboard. And this also part
of cardboard.
Yes. And this is battery.
This is a battery.
And this is light. And this pole we made up of paper. And this connects with battery and lights is on. And the car is a toy light.
Thank you, sir.
Hello friends, today I'm going to give the explanation about hydraulic brake system. A hydraulic brake system is a braking mechanism that are used to brake the fluid transfer into the system. This fluid transfer process is the control mechanism to the braking system. Hydraulic braking system are widely used in low speed and vehicle speed such as the Tata Ace. I am going to show my model.
Teachers and my dear friends, I want to introduce my smoothing machine. My name is Raghu Rajesh Dantula, standard 8A and division A and roll number 9. It made by a PVC pipe and a battery and a button. It can use by working like this. Anything like iron and wooden tools. It can polish any things like iron and wooden and plastic things.
Hello friends, my name is Uttar Shankar Gadi. My roll number is 13 from A. My project name is Solar Automatic Light Rechargeable. I have made Solar Automatic Light Rechargeable. The instruments which I use are 10K resistance in 4007 diode, 2 and 2222 transistor, 1 LED light, solar panel 5V, 1 3.7V LiPo battery. We have to charge for 3 hours, only for 3 hours, and it will work for 5 hours. So friends, now I will show how my project is working. So friends, this is my project. See, now I am in home, so that's why the system is absorbing the light is low, so that's why the light is coming. If I put any torch or sunlight, it will off. See. If I will remove, then it will come again. See.
Yes.
Okay. Then, so now I will tell you that in which condition it will work very hardly. The uses of this project is if we are going in forest area or in which place we do not get electricity, no light, then in such places we can use this thing. It will work very hard. The solar automatic light rechargeable can detect the sunlight is there or not. If there is sun means light, then it will stop the light and it will charge the battery. Means it thinks that the light has came, so no need of light and we have to charge our battery. And if the light has gone means dark, it means the solar will indicate that the light is on. Solar will automatically detect that light is not there, so we have to on our light. Then it will directly on his light. Thank you, friends.
Hello, all friends. I am Sairaj Praveen Keshagar, roll number 24, standard 88. My project name is Paper Fan. I have used cardboard box, cardboard paper, battery, on-off switch, motor, fan blade, two paper dish, wire, cutter and glue. First, from cardboard box, I have made stand and foundation of table fan. Then on top, I have fixed motor, the middle on-off switch and the bottom battery to supply the motor. Battery supplied to on-off switch, then again on-off switch supplied to motor and motor and fan blade. Motor operates, then fan blade runs. Fan blade covered with two paper dish. Then we on, then blade is runs. We hide the wire and battery discharge, then we buy the battery and new attached to motor. Thank you.
Good morning, teacher and my dear friends. On the occasion of Engineers Day, today I have made a battery operated car with a wired remote. It is completely based on cardboard. I have also attached two LED lights at front and back. It works on a 9-volt battery in it and it's connected to the remote. For back two wheels, I have used a DC motor inside it. It's also connected to the remote. It works on 4 cells. So let's have a demo. This button is working for reverse. If I press this button, the car gets back. Thank you.
Hello, my dear friends and respected teachers. I am Rudra Rajesh Darvi. I am from 8B. My roll number is 22.
My project name is candle powered boat. For this, the material we want that is the Tetra Pak, Pepsi tin, means metal piece, and the candle which I have used, you can see. And we also want two straws, and I have connected the two straws with this metal piece. I have made one gap and fixed the straws into that, and so that when the metal piece will get heated, so from the back from here the bubbles will come out, and when the bubbles will come out, our boat will run. See, like this there. So when the water will move, and the water will also move with it because of the bubbles. So we have to wait till the metal piece get heated properly. So you can see the vapors are coming of the heat, and the metal piece is also heated properly. It is too hot. So it is moving ahead now. It is slow, but when this metal piece will get well heated, so it will go fast. So now I will do it properly. Wait. So see, you can see that it is going forward. So now it is moving. You can also call it a steamboat because of the steam, it can move only.